Welcome students to MedPro classes. Myself Piraj Majumdar and we are continuing our manufacturing processes. So previous classes we have already discussed about the basics of metal forming processes, plastic deformation and yield criteria as well. And we also started the sheet metal forming process in our previous lecture. So today we will be continuing the sheet metal forming operation. So till now we have discussed the basic concepts behind the sheet metal forming operation, the piercing or punching operation and the blanking operation as well. So today we will move on to the other processes related to the sheet metal forming as well. Now you can see over here, this is the stripper. Okay, now look what happens. What is the stripper actually? Due to the release of the stored elastic energy in the stock left on the die, the stock tends to grip the punch as the punch moves upward. So if you can recall the picture as I show you earlier during the punching and blanking operation, so from there you can have an idea of stock. Let me once more show you the stock, the punch. So that was your stock, and in below it was the die, and this was the shredded part as you can see over here, and above the stock there was the die. Okay, so due to the release of the stored elastic energy in the stock left on the die, the stock needs to, this was the stock, okay, this one was the stock. So the stock tends to grip the punch as the punch moves upward. Okay, so that was your punch. Okay, now the necessity is that the use of a stripper to separate the punch from the stock. Okay, so this punch, when sometimes what happens, I earlier mentioned you, the shredded part sometimes gets stuck with this punch. So there is a need of separating that shredded part, the stock, from the punch. We have to use the stripper plate. Okay, now the force required for striping depends besides the material and on other factors such as the position, size of the punched hole as well. Now for example, thicker materials or a small hole in the middle of a strip require more stripping force than thin materials. Okay, so thick materials need more stripping force than thin materials, or sometimes a hole towards one of the edges needs more stripping force as well. Okay, and a punch which has a smooth side walls would strip very easily. Okay, similarly, more effort is required to strip punches that are close together. Okay, now a general estimate of the stripping force may vary from 2.5 to 20% of the punch force, but 5 to 10% is good for most of the applications. Okay, now a formula generally you can see over here. So I'll just omit this one. So here you can see over here, a general formula is used as known as it is given by PS. PS is the stripping force and it is denoted in kilonewton, and the formula is KLT. Okay, now K is the stripping constant. You can see over here the values are given over here: 0.013 for low carbon steels thinner than 1.5 millimeter with the cut at the edge or near a preceding cut, and it is 0.0145 for same materials but for other cuts, and it is 0.0207 for low carbon steels about 1.5 millimeter thickness, and it is 0.0241 for harder materials as well. Okay, now L is the perimeter of the cut, okay, in millimeter, and T is the stock thickness. So if stock thickness, the material to be punched out or cut, the thickness of the particular material is given as T, as the stock thickness. Okay, now one more thing you need to know while reading the sheet metal operations, punch and time axial. So you must take a note. These are very important for your MCQ purposes as well. So the most commonly used material for punch and die are tool steels. Okay, and for high production, they are using carbides. Okay, so this is the punch and die material. So you must take a note. That is tool steel for high carbon for high production. It will be carbides. Okay. Next, now look, I have shown you some of the most commonly used tools, you can say, just similar to the foundry tools we have earlier read during casting in the previous module, that is the module number 1. So now we will be going to read some essential tools or equipments, you can say, that are being widely used in sheet metal operations. Okay. The first one is the steel rules. Steel wool is just nothing like big thing. It is just simply a scale. Just simply a scale that you just generally use during your drawing or drawing a straight line. So steel wool is nothing but a simply a scale. Simply a scale, but only made up of steel. Previously you have used scales made up of fiber or glass. But these steel rules, which are being widely used for the sheet metal operations, are being made up of steel only. Okay, so soft materials are cut with a steel strip shaped so that the edges is the pattern to be cut. Okay, now nibbling. So nibbling, it is going to be your important for your MCQ purposes. Nibbling. So you must take a note about nibbling. Nibbling is a small punch. When a small punch is moved up and down rapidly each time cutting off a small amount of material, this allows a simple die to cut complex slots. So this is the nibbling. Okay, next, trimming. So look, this nibbling, trimming are very important for your MCQ purposes as well. Okay, so first is your trimming. So trimming means, you already have heard during trimming means while shaving the the beard. So generally nowadays what happens, most of you are using trimmers. From this term trimming, the word trimmers arrived. Okay, so trimmers help in reducing the size of your beard or mustache. Okay, so similarly, trimming here also means cutting unwanted excess material from the periphery of a previously formed component. That is the trimming. Now, this is the shaving. So, they are, you can say, are related to one another, shaving. Now, shaving is the accurate dimensions of the part are obtained by removing a thin sheet of metal along the edges. So, here you can see over here. So, this is the scrap, and this is the trimmed portion. This is the trimmed portion. Okay. Now here you can see, this is the die, this is a sheet metal, and this is the punch. Now this is one of the most important for your MCQ purposes. This is the lancing. Okay, so you must take a note of this lancing. Now what is lancing? Lancing is a hole when it is partially cut and then one side is bent down. So this one you can see over here. So hole is partially cut and then one side is bent down to form a sort of tab or louver. Okay, no metal removal, no scrap. So this is the lancing. So you must take a note that when a hole is just partially cut and then one side is bent down. Okay, so that is the lancing operation. Now squeezing. Squeezing is a metal, when metal is caused to flow to all portions of a die cavity under the action of compressive forces. So that is the squeezing, similar to extrusion. We will be having classes on extrusion in our later classes. So this is the squeezing and lancing. Okay, now look, we already know about the shaving and trimming operation. Okay, now let us have some idea on nibbling and notching. So these are also very much going to be very much important for your MCQ purposes. Now look, what is nibbling? So from here you can see the diagram over here. This is the nibbling operation. This one is the nibbling. Nibbling is the process of removing of metal in small increments. In small increments, that is a nibbling. Very important. Okay, so you must take a note. When a specific contour is to be cut in a sheet metal, a small punch is used to punch repeatedly along the necessary contour, generating the required profile. This one is the nibbling. Okay, so nibbling is resorted to when the contour is long. This contour is long. Contour means the hole. Okay, and a separate punch is impractical and uneconomical. So we are not going to have a separate punch for this particular operation, but we have to, you know, have a contour like this one, a long contour. So that operation is known as nibbling when you are not having a specific punch for this particular nibbling. Okay, now the punches used can be round, as you can see over here. This one is round or square depending upon the applications. Okay, now another very important operation is notching. So notching is method to cut a specified small portion of metal towards the edge of the stock. Okay, now one more thing I would like to share with you about the numerical part, that is, one formula will be there, that is your punching. So it will be your punching force. Okay, sorry, actually it will be your punching force. Okay, now punching force is the force to be exerted by the punch in order to shear out the blank from the stock. Now the formula will be, you know, from the actual shear area and the shear strength of the material. And the formula is very important, you must take a note. Formula is P equal to L, T and tau. So this is very important formula for solving the numericals coming out of punching force. Okay, so in punching you need to remember this formula as well. Now what is L, T and tau? From previously you know, L is the length, as in the stripper I already, you know, actually it is the perimeter, it is the perimeter, L is the perimeter, and T is the stock thickness, and tau here is the new term over here. Tau is the, you know, it is the shear strength, that is in MPa. So it is the shear strength in MPa. Okay, and this P is the punching force, and it is in Newton. Okay, so this you need to remember while solving the numericals on based on punching force. Okay, so now let us move to the next slide. Now here are also some of the commonly used sheet metal operations. You can see over here, this particular, you know, bending the sides, or you can say one of the edges or one of the ends of a particular sheet is known as, this one is hemming, and this particular operation by joining is known as seaming, and this is this operation curling. This is the curling you can see over here. Okay, now this is a diagram where you can you easily see how a stock, this one is a stock, or you can say the workpiece as well. So this stock is being, you know, applied some pressure or force, you can say, by a punch. It is written as small nosed punched, and it is being bulged. You can see over this phenomenon is known as bulging as well. Okay, so here it is shown very clearly, this one. So it is known as a bulging operation. Okay, now the next one is your fine blanking. Okay, so fine blanking, you know, it is a also you can say the sheet metal operation, one of the sheet metal operations as well. What happens here, dies are designed that have small clearances and pressure pads that hold the material while it is sheared. Okay, the final results is blanks that have extremely close tolerances. Okay, so here you can see over here, we are having this blank here, over here this is the punch, you can see over here. Now this is the contour punch. So this is the main punch, this is the contour punch, and they are saying they are having very fine, you know, close tolerances. So you can see over here, this particular, you know, when you are having a fine blanking means when you are having close tolerances, so the clearance is very small, you can see over here. Okay, so when the we are having close tolerance, that is the clearance is very small, that particular operation you are going to need a main punch and contour punch, and this is the blank, and this particular operation is known as fine blanking. Okay, now so here are some again you are having some more sheet metal operations, and they are very important as well for your MCQ purposes. Now look, first is the slitting. So slitting is nothing but a moving rollers trace out complex paths during cutting, like an can opener. So can opener, you know, just slitting means just slitting a, you know, just a simply cutting, you can assume as a blade cutting a plastic. With the help of a blade you are cutting a plastic, or with the help of a blade you are simply cutting a a cloth, that is the slitting. Okay, now perforating means multiple holes. When there are multiple holes which are very small and close together are cut in flat work material, so this is the perforating you can see over here. So multiple holes are being cut. Okay, now notching I previously told you, here again we are going to revise it. So you can see over here the notching operation is given over here. Okay, so notching is metal pieces are cut from the edge of a sheet, strip or blank. So when you are cutting the edge of the sheet or giving the edge of the sheet as some shape, that performance, that you know, that operation is known as to be notching. Okay, now slitting, you can see over here, this is the slitting. Okay, now coining. Look, coining is very widely used for making coins, medals and similar articles as well. So coining is going to be very important for you as well. Okay, for sheet metal operations. Okay, so coining is essentially a cold forging operation. So you know, cold forging operation, except for the fact that the flow of materials occurs only at the top layers, not the entire volume. Okay, so top layer will be concerned with this particular operation. Okay, now as I earlier told you that it is used for making coins, medals and similar articles. So here you can see this is the schematic diagram of performing the coining operation. So here is the work, this is in dark black, you can see over here dark black, and this one is the punch. So we are having this, you know, this contour as well as in the punch and die also. So we are going to have a coin shape material at the end of the operation. So here this one is the die and this one is the punch, and the material or the workpiece is the dark black one. Okay, so this is the coining operation. Now bending is a very important operation in sheet metal operations. So bending, you know, after basic shearing operation we can bend a part to give it some shape. So you can see over here, this is the bending are being widely used for different purposes as well. So bending parts depends upon material properties at the location of the bend. Okay, at bend what happens, biaxial compression and biaxial tension is there also. So compression and tension is there at the bending. Okay, now look very carefully at this particular, you know, my diagram. So look, this is your material. Now length of bend, this is the length of the bend. Okay, so that is L. And the thickness is, you know, T. This is the thickness. Okay, now here you can see over here, this is the bend angle and this is the setback. So bend radius is this one. From the center they are calculating the bend radius, this one. So that is given by the alpha, and this one is your neutral axis, this one. Okay, now this you will be going to need to solve the numericals. This formula, okay, the formula will be LB equal to alpha into r plus kt. So previously we have seen that bend angle, this one as alpha, the radius will be r. Okay, so here you will be needing this particular formula for solving numericals coming out of bend. So this is very important formula, you must keep a note somewhere. So this is given by bend allowance. Actually bend allowance they will be asking you in examinations, and we will be solving problems using this particular formula, lb equal to alpha r plus kt. So r is the bend radius, alpha will be your bend angle, and t will be your thickness of the material. Now k is here known as stretch factor or constant, you can say, for r greater than 2t. That means r is the radius, bend radius. When it is greater than twice the thickness of the particular material, then k should be used as 0.5, and when r is less than the twice of the thickness of the particular material, k should be used as 0.33. okay, so this is the formula you need to know and remember during solving problems based on numerical on bending. Okay, now the strain, this is somewhat this formula is very much important for gate purposes. Now this, the strain on the outermost fibers of the bend is given by epsilon, you know the strain. Okay, so it is given 1 upon 2 r by t plus 1. So r and t you already know the bend radius and thickness of the material. Okay, now the bending force, this is also going to be very important for your examinations regarding the solution of numericals coming out of this particular bending force. So bending force F is written as KL sigma UT T square by W. Okay, now what is the terms are given over here? As you can see over here, L is the bend length. So here, from here you can see this L we are going to be using in bending force. This L is the bend length, or you can say the width of the stock as well in millimeter. Sigma UT, from UT you can easily guess it is the ultimate tensile strength, that is in MPa, Newton per millimeter square. T is the plank thickness, W is the width of the die opening millimeter, K is the die opening factor. Okay, now K, value of K, these are the value of K we are going to be use in different conditions. When W less than 60, V bending is 1.33, we are using the value of K as 1.33, and for U bending we are using 2.67, and the H bending we are using 0.67 as well. Now when W greater than equal to 16T, there is the thickness, you know W is the width of the die opening. Okay, so in that case, if it is V bending, then we are going to have our formula of the value of K, that is a constant, is 1.2, and for U bending it is 2.4, and for H bending it will be 0.6 as well. Now for U or channel bending, force required is double. So in U bending, you know, the force required is double than V bending, and for H bending it will be about one half or V bending. Okay, so you know, for creating U channel bending, the force is maximum, then for V bending is the force, and the least force is coming to be when we are performing edge bending. So you must keep in mind, this is very important. For U channel bending, the bending force required will be maximum, and for the edge bending the force will be minimum. Now next operation is the stretch forming operation. Okay, now this stretch forming is one of the versatile operation of sheet metal, where we produce large sheet metal parts in low or limited quantities. Okay, so a sheet of metal is gripped by two or more sheets of jaws that separate it and wrap it around a single form block. Okay, because most of the deformation is induced by the tensile stretching, by applying the tensile force, the force on the form block are far less than those normally encountered in bending or forming operation. So there is very little spring back, you can see over here. Spring back, I already discussed in my previous classes. If you don't know the spring back, you can consult my previous classes on this particular module 2, metal forming. Okay, so there is a very little spring back, and the workpiece conforms very closely to the shape of the tool. Because the forces are so low, the form blocks can often be made of wood, low melting point metal, or even plastic as well. Okay, so this is the stretch forming. Now It is very popular. This stage following operation is very popular in the aircraft industry and is frequently used for to form aluminium and stainless steel. Okay, so you know, by applying tensile forces, this aluminium and sheets, stainless steels are being stretched. Okay, and can be used for different purposes. So low carbon steel can be stretched, formed to produce large panels for automotive and truck industry. So you can see from here, with the help of stretch forming, different you know, structures can be produced out of this aluminium or stainless steel, whatever you are going to be used. And we are going to be using this particular stretch forming operation in order to give shape to, you know, the different parts of panels of automotive as well as truck industry, and also in aircraft industry as well. So two most important applications of this stretch forming are in automobiles and aircraft industry as well. Now, stretch forming, this is a stretch forming operation. So you can see over here, tensile forces are being applied. Here is a die, here is a die, is force is given over here. So it is stretched, it is being stretched. So there is a stretch forming operation. Okay. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind, that is a strain. So strain for biaxial stretching. Now, look, it is a biaxial stretching. Okay. So we are having two axes. One is a, say, x-axis, and another is say y-axis. So we are having biaxial stretching of seats. So the strain will be coming out to be, one is epsilon 1 and another one will be epsilon 2. So it will be given by ln li 1 by l 0 1, and second will be ln i 2 by o 2. So I will be using for initial, so initial length by final. Okay, similarly for this one also, initial by final as well. Now the final thickness is given by initial thickness, that is the T, initial thickness was the T, and it is divided by E exponential to the power epsilon 1 into exponential to the power epsilon 2. So these two values, okay, you are, will be giving over here. Okay. So that is the formula of the final thickness. Now coming to the next very important process of you know, this sheet metal operation is known as embossing. Okay, embossing. So embossing is, you know, you might have heard the term of embroidery in our textiles. Okay, so designing of textiles, clothing, dresses as well. So from there you can correlate this particular operation of embossing. It is similar, much similar to that one we are being heard of during the textile or you know, different cloths as well. So it is a very shallow drawing operation. Okay, so drawing operation where the depth of the draw is limited to 1 to 3 times the thickness of the metal. So depth will be limited to 1 to 3 times the thickness of the metal. This one is very important. Okay, and the material thickness remains largely unchanged. So here you can see embossing dies. So this is embossing dies as well. So actually this one depicts somewhat of punch, but it is also die, as because you can see over here, this one has given a shape. So that's why they are calling this, you know, these both are dies as well. So, but you know, they are applying force on this particular die. So you can also correlate this one, this upper one, as a punch also. Okay. So these two are the embossing dies, and this one is the work. So you can see over here, we have to apply force from upside. So we are getting this type of embossing. Okay. Now clearance in percentage, as you can see over here, if the allowance for the material is 0.0075 given, then C is the clearance, should be 0.075 into thickness of the sheet. Okay, and is clearance is 1%, you can easily calculate that is 0.01 into thickness of the sheet. Now punching force and blanking force, as I earlier mentioned you, that this is going to be very important formula for your solving numerical problem. So again, I am giving you to have a recapitulation of the previous one. I earlier told you about the punching and blanking force. So you earlier know that L is the perimeter, T is the thickness, and tau is the shearing strength in MPa. So this is the formula you are going to need during solution of problems. Now here one more thing is given over here, that is the punching force for holes which is smaller than the stock thickness. Stroke thickness means the thickness of the workpiece. Okay, that is the stroke thickness. So when the punching force for holes which are smaller than the stroke thickness can be estimated as follows, as given by F max equals to pi d sigma by cube root of d by t. Now, capacity of press for punching and blanking. So press capacity, what is the capacity for the press? Okay, so it will be given by F max, maximum punching force, into C, where C is the constant and equal to 1.1 to 1.75 depending upon the profile. Now, it is very important for solving numericals also. These formulas which I am repeatedly sharing with you, you should take a note, as because they are going to be our key master in solving the numericals coming out of this piercing, blanking or sheet metal operation. So piercing pressure is given by tau s, shear strength, into pi into d is the diameter, d is the thickness. So that is the piercing pressure, and the strength is given by, you just have to multiply the sigma c, that is the crushing force, into pi by 4 d square, that is the area, cross sectional area. Okay, now let us discuss about the energy and power for punching and blanking. So ideal energy, that it will be in joule. So these are the formula parts you just have to keep in mind, or you have to remember, or you just have to note it down somewhere. That will be your the master key during solving the problems in numericals, of numericals coming out of this punching and blanking and other metal operations as well. Okay, so ideal energy is given by maximum force into punch travel, that is F max into P into T. P into T is the punch travel. Okay, now unit F max is in kilonewton and T in millimeter. Otherwise, use F max in newton and T in meter. Okay, where P is percentage penetration required for rupture. And ideal power in press, it is given in watts, and it was in joule. So it is power and it is energy. That's why it is given in watt. Watt means joule per second. Joule per second. So rate of doing work is power. So ideal power is given by E into N by 60. This E into N, and N is the actual number of stroke per minute. So that is the formula for ideal power in press. The actual energy is given by F max into P into T into C. Okay, and C is the constant that I already discussed with you, that is equal to 1.1 or 1.75 depending upon the profile as well. Now actual power in press, actual power is given by E into N, N is the number of strokes, by 60 into eta. Eta is the, where E is the actual energy and eta is the efficiency of the press as well. Okay, now shear on the branch. To reduce shearing force, shear is ground on the face of the die or punch. Okay, so it distributes the cutting action over a period of time, and shear only reduces the maximum force to be applied, but total work done remains shear. Now force required with shear on punch. So force required on the shear on punch is given by F equal to F max into PT by S, and P is the penetration of punch as a fraction, and S is the shear on the punch or die in millimeter. Okay, now next we are having a beautiful operation. So you can guess from here, you can see the picture, it is being performed on lathe actually. So the from the picture you can see it is being performed on the lathe, and it is known as spinning operation. Okay, now what is spinning? So spinning is a hole forming operation in which a rotating disc of sheet metal is shaped over a mail form or mandrel. Okay, now localized pressure is applied through a simple round ended wooden or metal tool or small roller which traverses the entire surface of the part. So mandrel or die or internal pieces, whatever you can say, you can just correlate it with the that core we used in making hollow casting, in casting. Okay, so core we generally used during producing of hollow casting, that is somewhat you can correlate with this mandrel. Okay, so internal pieces or die you can say as well is placed on a rotating axis. So rotating axis means just think of the spindle of the lathe machine. Okay, so that is the thing. So rotating axis like a turning center, you can see. Now a blank or tube is held on the face of the mandrel. Okay, Now, a roller is pushed against the material near the center of rotation and slowly moved outwards, pushing the blank against the mandrel. And the part conforms to the shape of the mandrel with some spring back action. The process is stopped and the part is removed and trimmed. So that is the spinning. So now you can have an idea of this particular thing. So look, this somewhat, you know, the chuck looks like the chuck, and this is the, you know, turning center. So you can correlate with the lathe as well. Now this is the workpiece, and he is keeping the mandrel as well. So it is this, with the help of this mandrel, he is giving the shape of this particular workpiece. Okay. So you can see over here. Now this is the, you know, original blank of the sheet. Previously it was similarly like a sheet of metal. Now it is being continuously rolled. Follower held in tailstock. So it is held in tailstock. Okay. Now form attached to headstock spindle. This is the form. Okay. Now final send comes to this one. So this is the spinning operation. Okay. Now coming to the numerical portions. So you can see over here. So thickness TC, and this is the alpha is the angle. TB is the another thickness of the previously, you know, sheet of the blank, or you can say, okay. And this is the mandrel. You can see over here. This is the mandrel. This one is the mandrel, this one is the mandrel. So this is the mandrel. Okay. So it is being pressed, giving a pressure on the blank so that it becomes a shape like this mandrel only. Okay. So this is the spinning operation, and TC. Now this you are going to need to solve the problem. Now this is the TC. This is the, you know, thickness, final thickness, you can say. So TC equal to TB into sin alpha. This will be the alpha. So you can find it from the shape of the mandrel as well, and also from the final shape of the workpiece as well. So TC equal to TB into sin alpha.